Hello students, so in this video we are going to start with systematic qualitative analysis and this is the fifth salt. So as usual we are going to detect one acid radical and one basic radical. Before going for the detection of the acid radical and basic radical, let us start with preliminary test. And the first preliminary test that we are going to see is the state. Okay, so if you can carefully observe the given salt, you can notice that it is crystalline, isn't it? So the state of the given salt is crystalline. And the second preliminary test is color. We can see that it is colorless. And the third one is solubility test. So just we will check it out. So in the test tube we are going to take a small quantity of salt. To this we are going to add distilled water. Okay, and I will shake it. Okay, so you can see that the salt is completely soluble in water, which gives the conclusion that the given salt is crystalline. Okay, so let us write it down. The heading is systematic qualitative analysis. We are going to make three columns. The first one is test, observation, inference, and we started with preliminary test. The first was state. The state of the given salt was crystalline. So the inference is chloride, bromide, nitrate, sulfate, ammonium, aluminium 3+ may be present. Okay, these ions may be present. Second, color. It is colorless. Barium 2+, zinc 2+, calcium 2+. These ions may be present. And the third preliminary test was solubility test. Salt plus water, shake well. The observation that we got is soluble in water, so the inference is crystalline salt. So then we will go for detection of acid radical group, and we will start with the first group, that is group 1, and the name of the test that we are going to perform is dilute H2SO4 test. So what we are going to do is, again we are going to take a small quantity of salt in the test tube. To this we are going to add dilute sulfuric acid. You can see here. So after adding the dilute sulfuric acid, so the given salt that is present in the test tube, look at the observation. Okay, look at this. So there is no action, isn't it? So let us note it down in the notebook. Group 1, dilute H2SO4 test, salt plus dilute sulfuric acid. The observation was no action. No action. Group 1, that is carbonate, is absent. Okay, this is the inference which we are getting after performing the test. So, because the group 1 is present, then we will go for group 2. So, the name of the test that we are going to carry out for group 2 is concentrated sulfuric acid test. So in this test, what we are going to do is, we are going to take salt, and to that we are going to add a drop of concentrated sulfuric acid. Make sure you are taking the dry test tube. Okay. So first I will be taking the salt in the test tube, in a dry test tube. To this I am going to add concentrated sulfuric acid. Whenever you are using the concentrated acids, make sure you are holding the test tube with the help of the test tube holder. Okay, so I am going to add a drop of concentrated sulfuric acid to the given salt. Okay, so you can see that we are getting the observation as no action. We are neither getting colorless gas nor reddish brown gas. So the inference is, the observation is no action. If there is no action, what we are going to do is we are going to add copper turnings and then we are going to heat it. So what we did is salt plus concentrated sulfuric acid, there is no action. If no action is there, then we are going to add copper turnings to the same test tube. Okay, hardly one or two pieces you can add to the test tube, you can see here. After that you are going to heat it. So look at the observation. Okay, so after heating, again we are getting no action. We are not getting any reddish brown gas, instead we are getting no action. Okay, so which gives the inference that group 2 is absent in the today's salt. Look at this, group 2 concentrated sulfuric acid test, salt plus drop of concentrated H2SO4. The observation that we had got was no action, which means chloride and bromide is absent. If there is no action, what we are going to do is we are going to add copper turnings and again heat, which we have already done. So the observation is no action once again. So the inference is nitrate NO3- is absent. That is group 2 absent. So because group 2 is absent, what we are going to do is we are going for group 3, analysis of group 3. So the test that we are going to conduct is test for sulfate. How to do that one is salt plus barium chloride solution. I am taking the salt in the test tube, a small quantity of that one. To that I am going to add barium chloride solution. You can see here the reagent bottle. Yes, after adding barium chloride, the observation that we are getting is white precipitate, which gives the inference that group 3 is present, that is sulfate ion is present. So we will go for the confirmatory test for sulfate, and how to carry that one is salt plus lead acetate. So I am taking one more test tube, in that I am adding a small quantity of salt. To this I am going to add lead acetate. You can see here. So look at the observation. Okay, so the observation is white precipitate, which confirms that in the given salt sulfate is present. Okay, so we will write it down in the notebook. So analysis of group 3, which we have carried out now, test for sulfate, salt plus barium chloride solution, we got white precipitate, and the inference is sulfate is present. Then we went for confirmatory test for sulfate. The test we had carried out is salt plus lead acetate. Again the observation was white precipitate, and the inference was sulfate is confirmed. okay. So in the given salt, the acid radical that is present is sulfate. So let us go for the detection of basic radical group, and we will start with analysis of zero group radical, that is for ammonium. We are going to check whether ammonium ion is present or no, and the test that we are going to carry is, in a salt we are going to take a small quantity of salt. To this we are going to add sodium hydroxide, okay. We are going to add sodium hydroxide. After adding sodium hydroxide, we are going to boil it on the Bunsen burner. Yes, you can see that I am boiling the solution, okay. Yes, after boiling the solution, I am not getting any pungent smell of ammonia, which means that zero group is absent, that is ammonium is absent. So write it down in the notebook. Analysis of zero group radical ammonium salt plus NaOH solution, and we have boiled it. The observation that we got is no smell of ammonia. Therefore, the inference is group 0, that is ammonium NH4 plus, is absent. Okay, so after that we will go for preparation of original solution. In the preliminary test we had conducted the solubility test, and there we had come to know that the given salt is crystalline and it is soluble in water. Because it is soluble in water, we are going to prepare the original solution in water. How to prepare is, take a little bit more quantity of salt in the test tube, okay. Yes, to this you add the distilled water, initially a little bit, and after that shake it well. Make sure the salt is completely soluble in water, okay, and then you dilute it. Like this. Okay, this is going to be your original solution which we have prepared now, and we will use it for further group identification. Preparation of original solution OS, salt plus water, it is soluble, therefore OS is prepared in water. So after preparing the OS, we are going for the identification of group of cation, that is group of basic radical, group 1 and group 2. In positive radicals, always it will be absent for the PU level. So no need to conduct the test for group 1 and group 2. If zero group is absent, directly you are going to conduct the test for group 3. But in the notebook, you are going to write that group 1 and group 2 are absent. Okay, just see here, OS plus dilute HCl, no PPT, group 1 absent. Second, OS plus dilute HCl plus hydrogen sulfide, no precipitate, group 2 absent. If zero group is absent, I am repeating once again, group 1 and 2, it will not be present for the PUC level. So you are not going to conduct any test for group 1 and 2. Just note it down in the notebook. Directly go for group 3. And the test that we are going to conduct is original solution plus ammonium chloride plus ammonium hydroxide. Yes, I am taking a test tube here. To this I am adding the original solution which I had prepared initially. take little bit, not too much. Add to this, we are going to add ammonium chloride. Okay. Original solution plus ammonium chloride plus ammonium hydroxide. You can see here. Okay. Whenever you are using any of the reagent from the reagent bottles, make sure you are shaking it well before using. Okay. Ammonium hydroxide, a little bit excess. So the observation is no precipitate. So group 3 is absent. So we will note it down. Original solution plus ammonium chloride plus ammonium hydroxide, no precipitate. Group 3 absent. Because group 3 is absent, we will directly go for group 4 now, and the test is OS plus ammonium chloride plus ammonium hydroxide plus hydrogen sulfide. So whatever we have added in the group 3, the same reagents are there for group 4 as well, and the only thing that we are going to add extra is hydrogen sulfide. So in this test tube already I am having original solution, ammonium chloride, ammonium hydroxide. Just I want to add is hydrogen sulfide. Okay, look at this, hydrogen sulfide. So look at the observation. You can see here the observation is white precipitate, isn't it? So let us write it down in the notebook. The observation is white precipitate, group 4 present. Because group 4 is present, we will directly go for the analysis of group 4 cation. Already we have carried out this test, OS plus ammonium chloride plus ammonium hydroxide plus hydrogen sulfide, and the observation that we had got was white precipitate, and the inference is Zn2 plus may be present. Zn2 plus may be present. So because we are getting Zn2 plus as present, what we will do is we will directly go for confirmatory test for Zn2 plus, and it is carried out by taking original solution in the test tube, and to that we are going to add sodium hydroxide drop wise. Okay, this is the test tube to which I am adding original solution which I had prepared initially, and to this I am going to add sodium hydroxide. Be careful, we have to add sodium hydroxide drop wise, don't add too much, that is in excess. Okay, so you can see the observation that we are getting the white precipitate, isn't it? So the observation is white precipitate which gets dissolved in excess of NaOH. When you are adding in drop wise, initially you will get white precipitate, but if you are adding excess of sodium hydroxide, okay, whatever precipitate was formed, it will get dissolved. Okay, you can see here, whatever precipitate was formed initially after adding sodium hydroxide drop wise, now it is dissolved in excess. Okay, so that we will note it down in the notebook. Yes, confirmatory test for Zn2 plus, original solution plus sodium hydroxide drop wise, we are getting white precipitate. Dissolved in excess of NaOH dissolved in excess of sodium hydroxide, and the inference is Sedn2+ is confirmed. So in today's given salt, the basic radical that is present is Sedn2+, and the acid radical that we had got initially was sulfate. So at the end we will write down the report. The positive radical in the given salt is Sedn2+. The negative radical is sulfate. The formula of the given salt is zinc sulfate. This is 2-. The name of the given salt is zinc sulfate.